Well, we started out with 64 teams in this tournament. We're down to three with 64 seconds remaining. Who will join UCLA on Monday night, Billy? What about the final 104?
The guy who will join UCLA is the guy that makes free throws the rest of the way. North Carolina now can afford to play solid defense, Jim, but they will go for steals. They find themselves in a position with possession of the ball now. So obviously, if they could take a lead with a three, it puts Arkansas in a tough spot. If they can just tie it up, they can go back and play solid defense. Very important that they score here. And Arkansas probably saying, how is this possible? Because they were up playing solid defense, great offense. North Carolina couldn't score for almost 13 minutes. And now Arkansas finds themselves, as they did against Kentucky in the SEC tournament, wondering how did they ever get in this kind of position.
Had a few unbelievable comebacks.
This year alone, the Duke game, the Wake Forest game in Winston-Salem. Of course, over the years, some incredible comebacks.
Calabria draws Corliss outside. A lot of time, man-to-man defense here. Stackhouse drives it here. Stackhouse to the line to tie it up. That was a set play. Perry Stackhouse, 1-1, and Jim, he got some pretty good one-on-one training this year.
Yes,
when he went 1-1 with Michael Jordan.
He says the score was about 18-10, but just the fact to go 1-on-1 with Jordan would give you a lot of confidence.
That was when Michael showed up in Chapel Hill for a practice in early January. Now two free throws to tie it. Williamson picks up his fourth with that foul.
Oh! See if Arkansas does a better job blocking out. Remember in the last one, Calabria almost got a piece.
69-68. Arkansas should look to score against this Stackhouse. Oh, Stackhouse almost got to it. One more foul for a 1-1. Would be a 1-1.
They don't want to put Scotty Thurman on the line. He just says no foul. Dean Smith wanted no foul. He wanted to have the opportunity, Jim, to have the ball with 10 seconds to go. That was the differential on the time clock and the shot clock. He just wanted to play solid defense there.
Well, this will be a 1-1 for Clint McDaniel. Almost 76% from the line. Stewart has missed the last two front ends of the 1-1.
Well, it still gives North Carolina even a nation a chance to go for a three.
Looked pretty cool on that one, didn't he? Kid from Tulsa, who grew up worshiping the Tulsa coach at that time, Nolan Richardson. Gives him a three-point lead.
Now, they got to think three, but take a two and foul if you have to.
The Ravens, back clicking away and calls a timeout.
No, they say four. A tie-up situation.
But it's going to be North Carolina getting it back.
Corey Beck can't believe the call, and I agree with him, Jim. I think that, number one, I think he had the timeout. And number two, if he didn't, I think he got fouled. Now, here you see Beck on the floor. There's no question that's a foul if it's not a timeout. It can't be a jump ball.
Timeout, Arkansas, granted. It is Carolina basketball because they had the arrow. They did not grant the timeout right away to Corey Beck. One timeout apiece. And Billy, this looks like a missed call.
No question about it, Jim. Here's Beck on the ball. Now you see a foul on Calabria. Beck then calls for the timeout. There's no foul called. There's no timeout called. And now Calabria gets an opportunity to call it a held ball. Carolina had the arrow, so they get the ball back.
Carolina.
Big call for Carolina.
We'll inbound it now with Calabria. Carolina down three. With 18 to go, you almost got to go for the three. And obviously Arkansas knows that. And who do they put? McDaniel on Williams. And he will really be shading him. Probably will not leave him, even if McGinnis makes penetration inside. They got Scotty Thurman on Calabria.
Well, Calabria
their hottest three-point shooter on the season. 0 for 8 today. Did he find a way to break out of it now?
Got to get the ball inbound.
See if Stackhouse strikes the taking again. Williams. McDaniel pulls it down. 7.5 to go. And McDaniel will shoot 2 now. Double bonus. Wrested away for Arkansas.
Jim, with that much time, you think he can still get a good 2 and foul anyway, as opposed to taking the bad 3. A little bit out of Donald Williams' range.
Donald Williams, who the first guard since Dale Goodrich, the average 25 in the final 4. A little bit out of range in that jump. McDaniel, who hit 2 big ones in a 1-on-1 situation moments ago, this time with 2. Carolina, Pat Sullivan. Carolina 5 down with 7.5 remaining.
I think they're going to go long to Wallace. Stackhouse coming out of the game right now. See if they're going to try to go long to Wallace. Pick up a quick foul.
Sullivan runs the baseline, flings it.
That's the idea.
Corliss retrieves it. And Arkansas is heading to Monday night for the chance to repeat. So count the basket at the end for Corliss. Monday night, the Razorbacks looking for the repeat.
Well, a team that repeated often, UCLA, goes up against somebody that would like to have their first.
Tournament wins now for Arkansas. And Richardson is going to add Gene Smith to his list of coaching victims. Terrific job by Arkansas in the second half, getting the ball to Corliss Williamson. And he was the key and set the stage for the excellent shot selection. And then that suffocating defense that kept Carolina from a field goal for almost 13 minutes.
Arkansas was up 11.
Saw that lead shrink to 1. They always find a way to make you hang on to the end. But it's UCLA and Arkansas set for the Monday night final in Seattle.